CBS presents this program in color.
On our show tonight, we're very happy to have that marvelous comedian from McHale's Navy, Tim Conway, and I think I want to thank you. About the best singer to come down the pike in ages, Mr. Jack Jones. Could we, before we get started, may we turn up the lights so we can talk to the folks, please? Do you have any questions you might like to ask? Oh, yes.
What's your orchestra leader's name and how does he
look? Our orchestra leader is Harry Zimmerman, and he's been with us for years, and I love him dearly, and you can see him right through that glass. Thank you for asking. That's Harry's sister. Yes, ma'am.
We have something for you. Maybe give it to you.
You have something for me? Sure. Yeah, come on up. Or should I? Come on up.
I'm getting a gift. Wait till I see it.
Oh, come on up. What's your name?
Miss Swan.
Miss Swan?
Yes.
Hi.
Hi, how
well,
are
thank
you?
Thank you. Let me see.
It's from that young lady over there.
To
she's
Carol
worked on it for a whole week.
From Nikki Marcus.
Yes,
can I open it now or should
you
I
sure
wait?
Can. Go
okay,
right
well,
ahead.
Stay here now, Miss Swan. One minute. In case it.
Don't go away!
No, it's really. What is it? Oh, I can't. I'm always nervous about opening. Anybody got a pair of scissors?
I thought she was going to be nervous.
See. Oh. Thing that it's a tube. Oh, it's awful. Oh, that's adorable. Look, can you see that? Adorable. I really appreciate it. Oh, gee, she's gorgeous. Thank you very much. I shall have this framed and I'll give it to our riders for their dartboard. Thank you. Don't you keep it now. Any other gifts?
Yeah. Have you ever kissed a man with a mustache and beard? And if so, did you like him?
Oh, you're a devil. He says, have I ever kissed a man with a mustache and a beard before? And if so, did I like it? No, I haven't. You want to crack at it? To bring out Tim Conway to say hello and answer a few questions that you might have. Anybody have any questions they want to shoot at Tim? Anything? Don't be chicken.
Good night. Thank you.
The gentleman over there.
Where you got the bald head?
Where'd you get the bald head?
Funny. Actually, I'm not bald. I do have my own hair. It's home in a box. I could have probably, if I'd known you were coming. I don't know. It just kind of came on me.
From birth.
Standing there eating soup one day and like, there's a hair in there.
The girl back there.
Yes.
Are you
going to do another TV series? I don't think so. We were doing the last one, Rango, and a fellow from the network that we were doing it for came in and said, don't do this anymore. And we stopped there, and I haven't done one since.
Stop it. It's the only Western I've ever liked.
The only Western you ever liked that we did?
Really?
Well,
Westerns,
and
I love that one.
She loved
so
it.
So did I. Well, if I ever find the guy that came in and said, don't do that anymore, I'll throw him your way. Thank you.
Any other questions?
I never saw the show, but I hear it was great.
I love it.
Yes.
Any
children?
Do I have any children? Yes, I do. I've been married 3 very happy years. 3 out of 6. Yeah, you know. So we have... I have 4 children.
Any other questions? There's a lovely lady there.
Are you going to do any movies in the near future?
Are you going to do any movies?
I'm just reading scripts every day. I don't know, you know, from one day to the next. They're just pouring in like crazy. So I'll probably decide by this weekend whether I will go into features or not. I'll let you know on that.
One more? Got it? Yes.
Yes.
The boy there.
McHale's Navy, where do you get your jokes?
Well, if you have ever seen the show, we had very few of them. However, those that we did get were usually written in the sand. You walk up the beach, and you'd walk along, and it'd be red, and you'd say, hello. The guy put in a lot of laughs. Ah! It seemed to work out pretty well.
Okay.
Well, we had a lot of writers on it. They were all sick.
I'm just going to say, don't go away. We'll be right back.
Oh, I'll stay.
From Television City in Hollywood, it's the Carol Burnett Show, brought to you by New Spray Jubilee, the kitchen wax that cleans as it shines, makes daily cleanups easier. New from Johnson Wax.
During the years when I was bringing up my kid sister, I must say that my husband, Roger, was easygoing and tolerant, except occasionally when he was under pressure, and then just about everybody got on his nerves.
$4.76. Boy, does she spend $4.59.76. $7.15. Okay, bring that over. On these.
Carol! Will you stop pounding around the house?
Be quiet.
Yeah, but my accountant is coming over and I've got to get these tax information together.
All right, I'll go out.
Be quiet.
Shh. I never thought I'd get mugged in my own living room. Hush. What's the matter?
Roger's thinking.
With what?
I heard that!
There goes Mount Vesuvius again.
Carol, let me ask you something. Is it too much to ask for a man to be
entitled to a
peace,
little peace
and quiet in his own house? A man's home is his castle,
and I'm the king!
If I'm the king, how come she eats like Henry VIII?
He's starting again.
Roger, forget she's my sister. Just look upon her as a tax deduction.
Some tax deduction. $600 lousy. She eats that much in apples alone.
Come on, sis. We'll make old Scrooge here happy, and we'll go into the kitchen and quietly starve to death.
But you guys, Gretchen's coming over. We're going to study together.
Gretchen? Is Gretchen the one I think she is, the one that's always staring at me with that goofy look on her face?
That's Gretchen.
What's with her anyway? She never says hello. She just stares.
Roger, it so happens that she has a crush on you.
Crush?
She thinks you're groovy.
I never said 2 words to the girl.
Maybe that's why.
Crush, now I've heard everything. Please get out of here.
That must be Gretchen.
Hi, Gretchen. Hi, Chris.
Oh, hi, Gretchen. How are you?
Fine, Mrs. Bradford.
Good.
Roger, say hello to Gretchen.
Hello, Gretchen. You look very nice tonight, Gretchen. Oh, boy.
Now, you girls, just sit down and study very quietly, because Roger's got a lot of work to do, and you can... Gretchen, you... Over here, Gretchen. I'll whip up some things in the kitchen.
Have an apple or 12.
All right, that's 9, 17, 34.
Kids, I'm trying to concentrate. Could you switch to bananas?
Sorry, Roger.
Tell me, Reggie. Chum.
Oh, all right. 9, 17, 34, 46. That's 10, 7. Carry your 1.
Carol!
I'll be out in a minute.
Could you?
You're crazy.
No, I mean he's so tall and masculine, mature and everything.
Ooh. He's an old grouch.
He's not a grouch. He's nasty. Like Humphrey Bogart.
Carol, I can't take it anymore. She keeps staring at me with that goofy look on her face.
Oh, honey, be nice to her. She's just a kid. You know, when I was her age and I was in high school, I had a big crush on my history teacher.
Yeah? Well, yeah. How long did it take you to get over it?
3 years.
3 years?
After all, he was very handsome and charming. It'll take Gretchen about 3 days.
Thanks.
No, you know, he was very kind. He sat me down and he patiently explained to me that he was more than twice my age and happily married, and I took care of it. I understood and I got over it.
That's it. That's what I've got to do.
All right. Here, take the cookies and the milk into the kids, and I'll be out in a second.
All right, I'll do it.
Okay.
Oh, boy. Hey, kids. I'm with Carol whipped up. Nice milk and cookies. Made those herself. Great baker. Wonderful housekeeper. I tell you, I don't know what I'd do without her. I love her madly. What a wonderful woman.
Well, how are we doing? Oh, Gretchen, are those cookies all right, honey? Or would you like to have a piece of cake? Chris, would you come in the kitchen with me for a minute? With
sure, Carol.
Yes, let's go into the kitchen for a minute. Well, Gretchen, how are things in your world? I'm glad. I really am. You're a very nice girl, Gretchen. You really are. I'm glad that Chris has you for a friend, Gretchen. I really am. Say, why don't we sit down and have a talk for a usually so busy when you come over, you don't have a chance to chat. But I'm not busy now. Why don't we have our chat? Mm-hmm. Okay. Say, you know, it's wonderful to be young like you, I suppose. Have a long, happy life to look forward to. Not like us old fogies. Oh, I know what you're thinking, and I think you're kind to think that way. You think older men are super, don't you? Yeah, but I'll let you in on a little secret, Gretchen. I've lied to Chris about my age. I've told her I'm 36, but I'm not. I'm closer to 56. Yeah, I know I don't look it on the outside, but inside I'm all wrinkled. Gnarled, you know, racked with pain. Rheumatism, arthritis, bursitis, gastritis, gout. You know, I'm so lucky to have Carol to take care of me during my few remaining years. I'm so thankful. Every morning she dresses me. And at night, when no one's around, she gives me some cookies floating around in Geritol. I've got false teeth, you know. You want to see them? And she puts on my Lawrence Welk records. I think he's super, don't you? A 1, a 2.
Chris! Hey, Gretchen. I don't feel like studying anymore tonight.
Oh, that's too bad.
Well, I'd best be getting back to my paperwork before these old eyes give out.
Don't you think you're overdoing it?
Hey, that must be Larry.
Hi, Larry.
Oh, hi, Chris. Hi, Carol. How are you? Roger, got the papers?
Yeah, listen, why don't you take them all? I haven't got the head
for
them.
Oh, Larry, this is Christine's girlfriend, Gretchen. Gretchen, this is Mr. Porter.
Oh, hi, Gretchen. Nice to see you. Listen, nice to see you.
There are two words I can use to describe just about the best singer in the country today, and they are Jack Jones.
I've flown around the world in a plane. I've settled revolutions in Spain. The North Pole I have charted, but I can't get started with you. Around the golf course, I'm under par, and all the movies want me to star. I got a house, a show place, but I can't get no place with you. You're so supreme. Lyrics I write of you, just for the sight of you. Dream both day and night of you. But what good does it do? In 1929, I sold short. In England, I'm presented at court. But you've got me downhearted, 'cause I can't get started with you. I'm downhearted, 'cause I can't get started. I've known a few sweet girls, some that were wild. I left a few crying, the others just smiled. But I never could linger in one little town, 'cause I've got so much loving in me, I wanna spread it around. I sang at some weddings, kissed a few brides, had me some high times, I took a few slides. Then on to the next town to look at what's there, 'cause I got so much loving in me, I'm willing to share. Sometimes I get lonely for a minute or two. I'll hop me a big bus, going someplace new. There's so many sweet lips I'm waiting to try. Yeah, I got so much loving in me, I won't stop till I die. Downhearted with every goodbye, but
There is no sport that requires more precise timing or physical alertness than the dangerous sport of bullfighting. The skill of its champions is measured by how close they can come to death itself. Now, here is one of bullfighting's most skillful champions, Matador Dag Herford. Mr. Herford, you'll be entering the ring any minute now.
Really? Okay. All right.
That's right. You know, it is Saturday.
It is Saturday already? Oh, gee, boy. A week really times when you're having a good flight, doesn't it?
Mr. Herford, I don't want to get personal, but are you really going into the ring in that drunken condition?
Oh, I hope so. I've tried it the other way.
Oh, I understand. I guess when you really come down to it, it's not easy getting into that ring.
Oh, you know it. I got 40 steps to go up.
Yeah.
You get all that adobe all over your knees, man. People throwing tamales on you. That's no good.
Let's get right to the fight itself, sir. It must be pretty frightening to see a bull come charging at you.
Oh, it sure is. You know how I must feel when I see two of them.
Two bulls?
Yeah, sure. On a hot day, I see four. When I was drinking that cheap stuff, I used to see a whole herd of them.
Yeah, I see.
That's why I quit drinking that lighter fluid.
Oh, that's... Yeah. I was wondering, could you explain a little bit about your outfit?
Well, this is your standard bullfighting outfit. You got your tight socks, and your tight pants, and your tight vest, and then your tight little jacket on. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What does that do?
Well, it makes my face real red and my eyes bug out a lot.
Yeah, I notice you make exaggerated moves with your cape. Is that for show?
No, that's to keep the fruit flies off me. You know, you get them bulls in that ring week after week. Oh, it ain't a plenty picture out there.
I can see that. Yeah. How many passes have you made at a bull?
Oh, I've made a few, but it's kind of silly. You know, so you get a date with one. Where are you going to take him? There ain't a joint in town.
Never thought of it that way. I can't help thinking, sir, you're a little heavy to be a bullfighter, aren't you? Exactly how much do you weigh?
Oh, I weigh 165 and 10 be 175.
But what's the 10?
The horn weighs 10 pounds.
The horn?
Yeah, I got gored by a bull one time, and I had to have an operation, and they just left the horn right in there, so I weigh 170 pounds. Before I cut that bull off, I weighed almost a ton. You talk about trying to get a night's sleep. You know how early those bulls get up.
Yeah. Oh. It'd be tough rolling over, too.
Oh, you know it. Yeah.
There's no chance. Say, how many ears do you have?
Two. How many do you have?
No, I meant, have you ever been awarded any ears?
Oh, no. I got a hoof once. So.
Oh, good. Can we see it?
Well, I don't think so. I've been letting my hair grow over.
Right. I see it there, yes. Do you have any particular tricks that you do with your cape?
Well, I have one trick I tried out in Tijuana. I take the cape and I wrap it clear around me, and then I just turn my back right on the bull.
Where do you go from there?
Right into the fifth row. No chance, right?
Yes. Say, what are those for?
Huh? These are bandoleras.
Oh, bandoleras?
Yes.
Those are the barbed darts you stick into the bull to irritate?
That's right. Irritate him.
We see
that.
You do that?
Well, sure. I'll show you how they work. See, what you do is you wait until the bull comes charging right at you. You hold him like this, and when he gets almost to you, you just stick him right in. Oh. Boy, I can see how that irritated him.
Well, sir, this has been very interesting, but I believe it's time for you to enter the ring now.
Uh-huh.
What is the first thing you do as you prepare to enter the ring?
Oh, the first thing I do is fall to my knees.
To pray?
No, I just fall to my knees.
You just go right down.
Fall.
I hear the crowd yelling now.
Oh, I thought it was rain.
No, it's the crowd. I suppose they'll want to see blood.
Yeah, well, I've never let them down.
You always bleed. Yeah, you always bleed. Yeah. You know, I hate to say this, but you're going into that ring drunk.
Oh, I hope so.
Were you on that cruise ship that sank?
Yes.
You know something?
What?
I think we're the only two survivors.
We are?
Yeah, the way I figured, we're on this island alone.
Alone?
Yeah. Oh, now, don't...
Don't you touch me! You stay away from me!
Oh, no, wait a minute, you should...
Leave me out!
Oh,
geez. Animal! Don't you try to unleash your animalistic passions on me!
I wouldn't do anything, really.
You bet you're not, Buster. For all I know, you could be Jack the Ripper.
No, I'm Fred the Plumber. I had a card. My wallet's gone.
Well, don't you try to take advantage of me just because I'm a woman. I know your type.
No, really, honestly, I'm not... Well, looks are deceiving. Do you think that I would... Oh, wait a minute. Gotta get control of yourself. We gotta build a signal fire here. Oh, in case a rescue ship comes by.
We'll never be rescued. I just know it. We'll never be rescued.
Oh, sure we will.
I'll just die here on this island. I'll be nothing but a bunch of bleached bones in the sand. I know it. Do you hear me?
Oh, I needed that.
I didn't need that.
Sometimes two are better than one, you know. Now, look, I'm sorry, but... You gotta learn to control yourself. Now, I'm gonna take charge here. I'm the man. And I'm also a Boy Scout. Troop 33, Cleveland, Ohio, Chipmunk Patrol. I got plenty of merit badges in photography and brushing my teeth, so now don't worry. I know how to find food, and I know how to find wood for shelter. Just stick with me, and you'll be all right. Okay, let's move out.
I found wood.
Gee, I'm sorry. Are you all right?
It's only dislocated.
Yeah, well, now, don't worry. Better get that signal fire going. You know, a ship might pass.
I hope it's a hospital ship.
Just look for anything dry that we can burn.
Okay.
Oh, here's some sticks over here.
Here's a piece of wood over here.
Oh, these will be fine.
Here's
just
one.
While you can. Oh, here's a great one.
Where?
Under your foot. Oh. Bring them all down here. There you go. Boy. Oh, you want me to save a couple for splints?
Oh, yeah. I'm getting hungry.
Oh, now, don't worry. Don't worry. Plenty of turtle eggs on these islands.
Turtle eggs?
Sure. All you got to look for is a rock. They bury them in the sand underneath the rock.
Oh, there's a rock.
I'll go to it.
Okay.
Oh, boy, here it is. All right, you just hang on to that. Broken?
I'll reset it later.
Yeah. Looks kind of good. Hey, look! Look! I found eggs! I found eggs!
Those are rocks.
I found rocks! I found rocks!
That's all right. Save them. They'll make good roughage.
Yeah, good thing. Those will be mine. Hey, look. Here's some coconuts. At least we can drink the coconut milk. Oh. Just stand back. I'll break one of these open.
You know, don't you think it'd be better if you try to break it open on this sharp point right here? By
golly, you were right on that.
If a ship comes, I hope you see it first. I won't be able to point.
You save these.
Hey, why don't we go deep into the underbrush and look for berries?
Good idea. All right. Wait a minute.
What?
Oh, you can't go in there.
Why not?
Well, it's liable to be dangerous. Liable to be a wild boar or something in there, so I better go first.
Oh, okay.
Right. Just, there could be a wild boar or something in there.
Yeah. I won't go in. You go.
Yeah, well, you wait here. Here okay. I go now. Help!
Are you all right?
Where are you? It was big.
Jeez.
about that size.
That was really nice of you, going in there all by yourself just to protect me. Yeah, you're kind of nice.
Well, gee, thanks. You got a little shoulder there.
I felt something a moment ago.
You did? Well, next time I'll pull my punches.
No, not then. I mean, before, when you came out and I was holding you and, well, you may not believe this, but I've always been rather nervous around men. And, well, golly, in all my 19 years, I've never been alone with a man before.
Well, neither have I. I've never been alone with a girl before. See how that, except once, of course, at our high school prom. We went up to Lover's Lane afterwards. But we were in separate cars, so, nothing going on. We hooked bumpers, but, that's
you know, back home, I never went out. One time, I tried to get on the dating game.
What happened?
They sent me over to Mission Impossible.
Darn guys, I tell you. You know something? Mm-hmm. I don't even know your name.
Oh, my name is Charlene Frisbee.
Charlene Frisbee. Yeah. That's a beautiful name, Charlene. Then you get the Frisbee and it goes downhill. But
what's your name?
Fred Partridge.
Fred Partridge.
Yeah.
And a partridge in a pear tree. I bet you get a lot of that.
Yeah, I do. I hate it when they yeah. Say, you know something? Do you think we'll get to know each other a little bit better?
Could be.
I mean, being here and all that.
Yeah.
You busy tonight?
I don't think so.
Yeah. You know something? Now, don't feel me forward on this, but do you believe in premarital handholding?
Well, if the couple is going steady.
Yeah. Guess we're going steady. Well, now I guess we should do what every other couple on a deserted island does. I mean, look for a bottle and put a note in it and throw it in the ocean.
Let's see if we can find a bottle.
Okay.
Lucky.
Here's one. By golly, right over here.
Yeah.
Hey, there's already a note in it.
Oh. It's a pop bottle.
I hope we won't be here long. Look. Oh, it's for you.
Oh. Once in the morning does it, the Green Phantom.
Stay tuned now for the second half of the Carol Burnett Show, right after station identification. Now, back to the second half of the Carol Burnett Show.
You know, this past year, television ratings have shown that the most popular programs on the air are old movies, good or bad. In keeping with that trend, the Carol Burnett Show now presents its condensed version of three old, bad movies.
Daryl F. Zaney presents The Jungle Kook, with James Stewart, Stuart Granger, Farley Granger, and James Farley. And introducing Stuart Stewart as Stuart Stewart, and Elizabeth Taylor as Ava's gardener.
According to the map, Harry, we should find the wild girl of the jungle right about here. And she'll lead us to the lost diamond mine.
Diamond mine, huh? Well, are you sure?
Well, it says here on the map. See for yourself.
Yeah, well, this looks like the clearing between the two stretches of jungle, but it could be the...
That must be the wild jungle girl. Cool it. We're friends.
Yeah, we're not going to hurt you.
Harry, come here a minute. Come here. I forgot to tell you this. I was told by the person who gave us the map that there's only one way to tame the wild girl of the jungle.
Oh, what's that?
Observe.
You try it.
Oh, no, thanks.
I know how you feel, but you want that diamond mine, don't you?
I think I'll try it. Yeah.
All right.
I'll do it again. Go ahead, Harry.
I pass.
You want to be rich, don't
Not
you?
Not that much, no.
Come on, Harry. No use, Harry. We can't tame her. Come on, we gotta find a lost diamond mine ourselves.
Hey, here come two more. Selma, it's your turn.
Twentieth Century Lox presents Pat O'Ryan and James Gagné in Sing Sing Ding-a-Ling.
Father. Father, you gotta hide me. You gotta hide me,
this
Father.
This is the police. Come out, Fingers. We know you're in there.
What did I tell you, Father? It's him. You gotta hide me. Father, you gotta hide me. Parish, Father.
Let's pray for it.
I'll hold it, Father. I'll hold him back. Don't worry, Father. Listen, you gotta hide me.
I'm sorry, son. I can't help you.
Father, you gotta help me. I swear, Father, I won't cheat anymore. Really, I'll reform. I'll refrain.
No, you've lied, you've cheated, you've embezzled. You must pay your debt to society.
All right, Father. Tell me how much it is. I'll steal it.
You have 2 minutes to come out of there, Fingers.
Come, son.
No, wait a minute. You can't turn me in. You're my brother, Father.
I know I'm your brother, son.
Oh, wait a minute. A brother, Father, wouldn't turn in a brother, son.
I'm afraid I must come.
Where did I go wrong?
I don't know. We both had the same upbringing. We both went to parochial school together. We went to church together. We went to the seminary together. But I became a priest, and you became a hoodlum. Who knows why, Tommy?
I know why, Dickie. Because Mother Superior always liked you best.
Fellini, Carlo Ponti, Michelangelo Antonioni, Marcello Mastroianni, and Joseph E. Levine present Shut Up or Your Face.
No, no, Tony, you gotta leave now because if Pietro, he's gonna be here any minute. You gotta go. He'll see you here. You must leave.
No, not now. Just one more minute.
No, you gotta Pietro!
Angelina! You make a kiss to kiss with Tony.
Oh,
Angelina! Angelina! Oh, my goodness.
Pietro, let me explain.
Explain? Yeah. What is there to explain? What are you going to tell me that I don't see, I don't hear with my own eyes?
Wait!
Wait for what? You're going to show me some more? I don't want to see no more! Angelina, how can you bring him here to my house on my roof that I built with my own two hands? Angelina!
Please, Pietro, forgive me, please.
Don't forgive him. This is something it's not so easy to forgive. Angelina, this is real hard stuff.
Pietro.
No! Get away, shut up your face! Your house to break up. Angelina, Angelina. I told you when you love me. I told you when you love me. I thought keep on. Keep your hands off her. I told you.
Got younger.
And stronger. I told you when you knew that you love me. I'm 80. You're 20. It's a no good. It's a no work. But you say it's going to be all right because you love me.
I do love you, Pietro. I love you.
Yeah, you love me, but you're kissing him.
It's just a one kiss. It's not so hot. He's got chapped lips.
You're making me feel better. No. But it's a no good. No. It's a no work. No, take your hands off of me. There's some things I can't forgive, Angelina. There's some things I can't stand. I can't stand when a man can't trust his woman. And a woman can't trust a man. That's it, Angelina. We're through.
Where are you going?
I'm going home to my wife.
Something from somebody. big horse.
Give me a buckaroo and let me wahoo, wahoo, wahoo. I never could sing a high-class thing, good music I never knew.
But you can wahoo, wahoo,
wahoo.
Give me those wide open spaces.
'Cause I'm just like a prairie flower,
growing wilder by the hour.
Oh, give me a moon, a prairie moon,
and give me a girl, it's true, and let me wahoo,
wahoo,
wahoo, wahoo. Deep within my heart, there's a melody,
a song of old San Antonio, uh-huh,
where in dreams I live with a memory.
Beneath the stars all alone,
moon in all your splendor,
know only my heart. Call back my rose, rose of San Antonio.
Lips so sweet and tender, like petals falling apart.
Speak once again of my love, my own.
Just a broken song, empty words I know,
to live in my heart all alone.
I cut out one night for the Alamo,
and rose, that rose of San Antonio. Hey.
There goes my baby with someone new. She sure looks happy while I'm so blue. She wasn't my baby until he stepped in. Goodbye to romance that might have been. Nothing more to say but
bye-bye love, bye-bye happiness, hello loneliness, I think I'm gonna cry. Bye-bye love, bye-bye sweet caress, hello loneliness,
I think I'm gonna die.
He's an old cow from the Rio Grande, but his legs ain't full and his cheeks ain't tan.
I'm a cowboy who never saw a cow, never roped a steer, and I don't know how. I sure ain't fixing to start it now.
Yippee-i-yo-ki-yay.
Yippee-i-yo-ki-yay.
I'm an old cow from the Rio Grande, and I come to town just to hear the band.
She knows all the songs that the cowboys know,
about the big corral where the doggies go.
She learned them all on the radio.
Yippee-i-yo-ki-yay. Yippee-i-yo-ki-yay. I'm so glad we had this time together.
just get started, and before you know it, comes the time we have to say so long.
The part of Gretchen was played by Ruth Buzzi. The Carol Burnett Show has been brought to you by Pall Mall Gold 100, extra long at both ends so it travels the smoke farther for greater mildness. Puff for puff, tastes milder than ever.